Hello friends, welcome to this tutorial. So in this tutorial we will be building a very simple book search application. So as you can see here on your screen, this is the end product of this tutorial. So basically let me show you the demo of this application. So let me write any topic regarding I want to search books. Let's suppose I write programming language of PHP. So as I click on this button search books, 10 books will be listed here. So you can see here the title of the book is there, followed by the author name and a small thumbnail of the book and a button of read more. So if you wanted to read more about this book, you can simply click this button. So as I click this button, you will be redirected to the books page. In this case, this is Google Books page. So this is valid for all books. You can see here, let me just click any book, random book. So let me just read more about this book. So I will be redirected to this book's website, so you can read more about this book. So this is a very simple application by which you will get to know about how to interact with the Google Books API and how you can build some awesome applications like this. So let me begin, and I'm using Sublime Text for this application. You can use any text editor of your choice. So let me just walk you through the structure. That is, index.html is the page by which we are just this is the page where we are just have this form of search books and a button. So I have just included the materialize.min.css. So materialize is a framework for HTML and CSS. I have included my custom mystyle.css file, and I have given the title of book search software. So I have just created some markup here of form. I have created a form and I have given ID of my form. In that I have created a one input field of type search, and I have given it a ID of books, and a label I have given also, that is search books. After that, a simple button is there of red color and it has a label of search books. So as soon as I click that button, a random list of books will be generated. So lastly, I have a div and I have given an ID of result. So in that div, we will be populating the results that are coming from the API. So this is the index.html file and this is the mystyle.css. So I have just written the code for this. So I have just, this is my style sheet, that is custom style sheet. So all the code is there in the description, so you can download all the code here. So lastly, I have included the jQuery and materialize.min.js file and also my custom myscript.js. So let me just create this file. This is the main file. So let me just click on new and save this file as myscript.js. And first of all, I will just write the simple code of jQuery, that is document.ready function, and I will just write here return false. So this prevents the auto completion, the auto submitting of the form. So if I don't write this line, then the form will be auto submitted and this line of code will not get executed. So this line is very much important of return false. So after that, I will need to target the form that I have created. So I am targeting by ID name, that is my form dot submit. So submit is a event handler. So as soon as my form is submitted, these steps will be executed. So first of all, I need to collect the value that was entered into the input field. So how that I can collect that value? By just creating a new variable of search and by just getting the input field value. So there is a method in jQuery of val. Val stands for value, and I am getting this value by just writing the book's name. So this is the ID name that I have given in the index.html file. So you can see here I have given the ID of books and I am just getting the value here, dot value. So this will return the actual value that was typed by the user. And after that, let me check the value is null or not. So if the value is null, then I will be just alerting the user that please enter something in the field. first. So in the else part, if the field contains something, then we have to execute these steps. So first of all, I just need to create some variables: where URL, where image, image of the book, where title. So this will hold the title of the book, and lastly we have author. So this will hold the author of the book. So after creating these variables, we just need to send a get request to the API. So we will use the $.get method of jQuery, and this is the URL that we will be sending the request to: https://www.googleapis.com/books/version1/volumes?q. So we are querying this API, and we will be followed by is equal to, and we will just concatenate the value that we have got in the search field, that is this variable. So I will just put a plus sign, and after that search. So whatever the user has entered into the field will get concatenated in this URL. So after that we will just write function. So this is the callback function. So when the request get executed successfully, and when we get a response, we will be processing that response. So let me just console.log the response. So let me see the response is coming or not. So let me just save this file and go to my directory. So let me just go to localhost. So this is app/index.html. So you can see here this is the input field. So let me just right click and go to inspect and go to console. So as I write PHP here and click on this search books button, search books. So now you can see here a object has been returned to me, that is it contains an array of items. You can see here an array of 10 items has been there: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 books is there. So each book contains its title, author. You can see here the title is there. If I scroll away, authors is also there, publisher, published date. So these much of information is there for us. So this is a JSON file that is returned from the API. So now this JSON file that we need to process. So what we can do here is that we can just put a very simple for loop to process this array which has been returned to us in the form of response. So now we can just write a simple for loop for I is equal to 0, and I will run until the length of the array has been reached. So we can simply write response dot items. So items is the name of the array, and dot length i++. So first of all we need to get the title of the book. So for that this much of code will be necessary. So let me just copy it. First of all, and paste it. So first of all, I have just manipulating the title variable that I have declared early on. Title is equal to, and I am just creating a new h5 variable, h5 tag, and I am putting a class to it, center line. So this is a materialize.css class. It will center the heading for me, and white text, it will make the heading white for me. And plus I am just concatenating the response that is coming back from the API, response.items double square bracket. In that square bracket we have putting the variable of i.volumeinfo.title. So this is the syntax that is returning from the API. So this will return the actual title of the book. plus, and we are just closing the H5 tag. So this will be the title of the book. Similarly, we will copy paste for the author also. So let me just copy paste author. So in the place of title, we will just have author here, and just replace this with author also. So authors is an array, so it is not a property. So we need to get authors here, authors. So authors is an array. Depending upon the book, we can have one author, two authors, or three authors. So authors is an array, so that is why we have put a S here. And after getting the author, the last thing that remains is the image. So let me just copy the code for it. So this is image. So let me just copy it. So I have just manipulating the image variable that I have created early on, that is this image variable, and I am just creating a new image variable here with the help of this jQuery selector image class, and I have assigning this custom CSS class that I have created in my mystyle.css. This is the custom class that I have created, and I have assign a card class, so it will be making my image a card, and some shadow around it. So this is Z depth 5, and I have given the ID to it dynamic, and after that I have put a break tag so that our images will be there right after one another. So this portion I am creating, first of all the thumbnail of the image, and after that a break tag is added. After that, this button is appearing right now of read more. So this part I am creating in this line. A href tag is added. So this href tag will be containing the response that is there from the API. So this is the info link that we are just generating. Again, the same syntax, response dot items. So items is the name of the array. This is a variable that I am just using, I. dot volume info dot info link. So info link is the link by which we can read more about this book. So if I click this button, I am redirected to this website address. So this is the info link that is there. So this info link will be concatenating with this href variable, and after that I am just closing the href tag, and I am just creating a new button and putting an ID to it of image button, and in my style.css I am just styling this image button ID. I am giving a position of relative left to minus 10 pixel, top to minus 8 pixel, margin bottom to 15 pixel. So just for styling purposes, and I have given a class of button red aligning, and I have given the label to it read more. Close the button and close the anchor tag. So this is the three main lines of code that you want to write in order to fetch the title, author, and the image of the book. So lastly, we have the URL that of the image that we want to fetch. So for that, a simple line of code will be there. So let me just copy it and paste it in the browser, in the editor. So this is the URL variable that we have declared early on, and we are fetching the URL of the image in the same fashion, response dot items. So items is the array, dot volume info dot image links dot thumbnail. So this will fetch the thumbnail of the book's image. So after fetching the thumbnail of the image, we just have to attach this thumbnail to the image source attribute. So you can see here we have not declared the source attribute of the image. So now we will be attaching the source attribute by this method, image.ater. So this is a function in jQuery. So let me attach the source attribute to the actual URL that we have fetched, URL. So this will attach the image URL, and after that we just have to append this title author image to the actual result div. So we have created a div of result. So now that we have fetched all the details, at the end we just need to just attach it to the result div. So for that we will be making use of the append to function of jQuery. So title is the name of the variable and append to is the function in jQuery which will append this data to the actual div. So we want to append it to the result div, and similarly the author is also author.append to result, and image also append to result. So notice that order is very important. First of all the title will be appended, followed by the author name and then the image. So if you make mistake in the ordering, then the formatting if you just move author up and title down, so it will be not good for you, because it will make formatting less attractive. So the order is important: title, author and image. So this completes our script now. So if I just save the script and go to my, this is my project, that is localhost app index.html. So if I search php here, search books, so now you can see here the title is white color, so let me just make it black so that you can see here black. Let me also make it black also, because the background is white so you can't see. So let me just write here php and click on search. So now you can see here we have successfully generated 10 books here of php. This is the title, this is the author name, again this is title, this is authors. So let me just add a by here before the author name so that it looks attractive. So let me just add a by here. Let me save this. You can write anything, JavaScript. Let's suppose I want to search books of JavaScript. So now you can see here JavaScript books are there, JavaScript. This is the title, this is the author, this is the image. So if I want to read more about this, I can just click on this link and I will be redirected to this page. So this is a very cool application. You can search any topic. Let's suppose money. You can see here money books are there. So if you click again, 10 books will be more generated. So total number of books will be 20. So this is a Ajax driven application that is taking help from the Google Books API, and we are generating the response back. So thank you guys for watching this video. I think that you will get to know about this API more. You can play with this API and create some useful applications from it. So if you like this video, please like it and also share this video with your friends, and I will be seeing you in the next video. Until then, thank you very much.